Brilliance Audio presents Aftershocks by Marco Close. Performed by Luke Daniels. Even from the windows of a prison, Rhodia was a beautiful place. Aiden liked to spend the half hour between breakfast and morning orders sitting in the central atrium by himself. From 700 meters up, the panoramic windows offered a stunning view of what seemed like most of the southern half of the continent. The graceful and elegant arcologies of the capital rose into the sky in the distance, so tall that on some days their tops disappeared in the clouds. Beyond, the ocean shimmered, turquoise and blue. For variety, the Rhodians moved their POWs from one section of the detainment arcology to another every year, each time facing a different cardinal direction, so every prisoner could have a change of scenery. Last year, Aiden had a stunning view of the great snow-capped mountain range that divided the single continent of this planet. This year, it was the distant city, ocean, and tranquil skies. He had been a prisoner of war for 5 years, but Aiden still hadn't quite made up his mind whether a beautiful prison was really better than an austere one. At the end of the war, right after his capture, the Alliance had used the warships of their defeated enemies to hold POWs until they could figure out what to do with them. By the time the surrender treaty was signed, Aiden had spent 6 months in a two-person berth on Aggression battlecruiser, sharing the tiny space with a surly lieutenant colonel from the Blackguard Infantry. The food had been barely edible. The Alliance had fed them the surplus military rations they found when they took over the Gresham depots, and Aiden hadn't seen sunlight the whole time. When they finally transferred him to the detainment arcology, he had lost almost 10 kilos of muscle mass from living in low G for so long, and sharing crew facilities made for 500 with almost 1,000 other POWs had been claustrophobic and nerve-grinding. But he had dealt with it, because it was impersonal, utilitarian, and expected. They had lost the war, and they had to take what was served by the victors. The detainment arcology here on Rhodia was a prison, but it was a posh one. Back home on Gresha, no amount of money would buy a living space with a view like this. Gresham buildings did not reach a kilometer into the sky. Even the food on Rhodia was good, which had vaguely annoyed Aiden after a while because he had to moderate himself and work out more to keep the weight off. It all seemed a little like the Rhodians were rubbing it in. "Look where we can lodge even our captured war criminals. Look what we can afford to feed you. Just look at the view you get to enjoy every day." There was no mistreatment, no disrespect, just detached professionalism from the military police that ran the prison. They had a barber, a theater, a mess hall, a gym, an outdoor garden concourse that jutted out of the facade of the arcology in a 100-meter semicircle, private rooms, and personal comm tabs with limited and curated access to the Nemosyne, the system-wide data network. The only thing that made it different from a resort hotel was the security lock at the far end of the atrium, which only let you through if you were a Rhodian MP and stunned you into a 30-minute stupor if you weren't. But the fact that he couldn't leave whenever he wanted made it a prison, no matter how pretty the views were. The soft, two-tone trill of an official announcement interrupted Aiden's thoughts. Even the address system in the atrium was calm and low-key to preserve the tranquility of the place.